10 steps approach to personal and professional growth. The following are the 10 steps that lead to personal and professional growth. Number 1, awareness. One should be aware of existing behavior, including thoughts, feelings, images, sensations, and actions that are experienced as problematic. As examples, we can discuss the following. A. Catastrophic thoughts. For example, thoughts like, if I express my true ideas and opinions, my colleagues or superiors will think I am stupid, or my vice president, supervisors and staff would not think I know everything and will not have faith in me, or will try and take my position. B. Distressing feelings, for example, anxiety, depression, or guilt. C. Disturbing images, for example, an image of yourself as ineffective in your position, unsuccessful leader, or a poor decision maker. This is also known in the early stage in one's career or promotion as the imposter syndrome. Discomforting sensations, for example, generalized anxiety, headaches, shoulder, stomach, or back pain. E. Ineffective actions, for example, procrastination, inhibition, ineffective communication, listening and or speaking, poor decision making skills, and poor managing or leadership qualities. The second step is dissatisfaction. Dissatisfaction with present behavior can either produce motivation for change or the extinction of awareness through various psychological and or outside influences or distractions. For example, Daniel, obsessive compulsive behavior and excessive alcohol and drug use. Third step is affirmation. People often justify their behavior as needed or valued. Suppose there was a very smart woman who valued her ability to multitask, yet her directors and staff saw this behavior as not valuing them, being distant, and not involving them in decisions. Inadvertently, projects fell through the cracks because she would often forget. Communication between her departments became more strained because they all needed to stay on her good side. She did not fully comprehend the gravity of the situation until the president of the company hired an expert to work with her and her division. When this affirmation step is omitted, people frequently undermine, sabotage their motivation, for sense with self-blame or finger-pointing, for example, blaming others. The fourth step to personal and professional growth is responsibility. For example, some people in the workplace may have a chip on their shoulders. As a result, and as the previous example disclosed, their personal thoughts can be punitive and harsh, as can their behavior towards others. Their actions can also be either too kind or too harsh given the reality of the situation. As a result, they are ineffective and cause themselves and others grief and the organization time and money, with the bottom line being they come across as victims displaying some of these behaviors. For example, attention seeking, need for admiration and lack of empathy, feelings of inadequacy, submissive and pinging behavior, or preoccupation with orderliness, perfectionism, and control. On the surface, the symptoms may appear to be diametrically opposed. However, the underlying issue is the same, and resolution to this challenge is to take personal responsibility for one's life, not blaming one or others. This must be a major first step toward becoming a more satisfied individual, an appreciated co-worker, and a successful leader. Fifth stage, personalized goal. Set an achievable goal that is a sense that is under one's own control rather than dependent on someone else's approval. Trying to gain another's approval may be regarded as a desire or want, but not a personalized goal which is under one's own control. Focusing attention and energy on personalized goals increase one's sense of personal power. Conversely, focusing primarily on desires or approval by others tends to increase one's sense of powerlessness and vulnerability. The sixth step to personal and professional growth is demoralization. Frustration and demoralization often occur at this stage when one discovers that steps 1 to 5 do not automatically produce change. There is often a mental struggle going on inside of us where one party is wanting to quit, but the other knows that if we walk through this stage, then success will be forthcoming. The seventh step is intention. A strengthened resolve to give the goal implementation process vigilant attention is required at this critical stage. This is the step at which one's personalized goal is translated into an intention to change. An intention to change does not guarantee change. However, it does have more action potential than wishing or wanting to change. Each step to personal and professional growth is action. One's intention is then translated into specific action steps. These steps must be intentionally repeated several times until the new behavior begins to be expressed automatically. This frequently takes more time and attention than people are willing to devote, but success is assured to those who preserve and apply sound problem solving, decision making, and implementation skill. The ninth step to personal and professional growth is self-support. At this stage, one learns to support himself through the period of vulnerability that occurs right after one lets go of the old familiar pattern of behavior and up to the point where one begins to feel secure with the new behavior or habit. One must prepare consistent mental and physical behaviors until the experimental behavior is firmly established, thus requiring increasingly less attention to maintain the sense. A personal or professional mentoring group can be very helpful at all stages, but especially this stage. Think of them as our personal board of directors. Corporations have them, why not us? The last step to personal and professional growth is sustained change. In last, we have to apply a step of this process to the small and large challenges that life presents to us every day, and a happier, more successful life will be ours. In this way, the old unhealthy patterns slowly fall to the wayside and the new patterns build up momentum and show themselves to us in ever self-fulfilling and profitable ways.